Okay. So in the previous and prior session, like before that, whatever we did, okay, it's just we've done only two activities. One is user creation and implementation project creation. Okay. So which user we created? We created a user called Cloud ERP. I'm going to log into the same user. So for this user, we assigned the three different roles. Cloud ERP. Just there is some issue. Just I'm refreshed instance URL. It will get resolved. Seems to time out, so that is the reason it taking the error screen. Okay, fine. So we created our user with that ERP, Cloud ERP, with that is the name, and these are the three roles we assigned to that user, which will give the privileges to these areas. Right, done. After creating that implementation project, what we did? We navigated to functional setup manager. So how to navigate? Setup and maintenance. This task access will be getting because of application implementation consultant role which we assigned to this user. It will take us to FSM homepage from where you can enable the offerings, you can create the project, and that is a place to complete the system related configuration also. So to create the new project, I have to click on implementation projects. And from here you can create any project. What is the process to create the project? So just give the name and you can give the specifications. Then click on next. What are the offerings you want to select? Offerings as well as options, specific options within the project. You can just select in the next step and you can create the project. Okay. Then click on next. Here you can select the offerings and options. I'm just selecting financials. So what are the modules you want to implement? Those you can select here. Supplier invoicing means payables, expense, fusion expense, fixed assets, receivables, advance collections, revenue management, intercompany, and budgeting. Some other analytics related reporting and all you can select. So after selecting, anyway, this process already we just completed. So high level I'm taking it. Then say save and open project. So this is how we'll create the project. Then automatically system will create the task list. Okay, it will take some time.
Lakshman, one quick question, Lakshman.
Please.
When we are creating the user and upon assigning the role, right, there is something called assignable. What does that mean?
I'll take you through that. That means like that role can be just taken into other role assignment or not. Custom roles creation time, just I'll give you that point. But now anyway, it won't impact anywhere in our process. Okay.
Okay, one more question. Is 13 released in the market?
The 13 in the market, it's not stabilized. Still, clients are using 12 only.
And we will be still using 12 to practice, correct?
Only, yes, same. This is the 12 instance. You can see that version also from. Eleven point 12. This is the release 12. Okay, fine. Okay, so this is how we can create the project, and we discussed we can change the status and we can reassign to someone else, and we can change the status to the offering what we selected. If you expand this offering within that, you can find the different options, option related or some sub task list or task you can find within this. Here we can change the status also. That's what we have seen in our previous session. Now we'll go to the same project. What are the project we created? So how we can navigate to our project? Anyway, once you take this navigation, we'll be able to see all the projects which are created in this instance. If you have access to Functional Setup Manager, you'll be able to see all the projects which are created by other users also. But reality, when you are working for any client, we don't create these many projects. That number would be one or two. You may go with the three also, where you will be splitting offering wise project. Fine. So what are the project we created, we assigned to our current user. So directly that project will get defaulted. So on the selection, what you are going to do. One second. Fine. So directly we'll get to our project. Please.
Lakshman, I just wanted to, you know, just like in EBS, we have how to run the list of active users or inactive users. Do we have that in, you know, once we have the list of users?
Yeah, we have. We run a report. Yeah, user based reports, we have, you can do that.
Okay.
Reports. Yes. Okay, so just click on setup and maintenance. Just give me a second, I'll switch to other network. Just one second, please. Just seems to there is some issue. Okay, fine. So just click on implementation projects. Now to see the project, what are the project is assigned to current user, you can click on overview. So directly it will display the project which is associated with this user. Seems to somebody, okay, to we only created. So this I am going to remove. Just now we created this project. I'm just going to remove. Since we created from this user, system assigned automatically to the same user. This project I am just removing. We don't require this. So now this is a project we have. You can click on this project and it will open the entire definition. This is header level information. So just wait task level. And if you want to create any report against this project, maybe for entire offering level, or say for examples, for example for payables, you can just click on this view report. It will give us all the information, what are the tasks we have as a part of that. So task list, you can see your enterprise related applications or objects. Primarily you may just go through what are the tasks you have as a part of this payables implementation. That instead of opening that information in the report, you can expand and you can see from here also. The same like still you can expand. These all tasks you will be able to see in the report if you just click on this. So I want to see in the PDF. Only related to payables. We selected only payables related option. So only payable related setups. This is how you can generate the documents to just go through all the relevant information. Okay. So now what we can do is just we updated the status for this, and if you want to assign these financials for any one of the resource, you can select it, then you can click on assign task. And just to which user you want to assign, you can just assign to that user by clicking on create. Here you can give the username as, so for example, cloud. Here we have one user called as cloud. You may assign these financials to this user. Just say apply, click on done. and say save.
Is assignment can be done by any of the user or a specific designated user?
Who has access to this FSM, they'll be able to do it. Okay, we require FSM access. They can do it. Okay. So now here, so we assigned to multiple users. In the previous session, we assigned to one user. Now we assigned to different user. If you expand any one of the class.
Hi, Lakshman, I have.
Please.
Hi, Lakshman, I have a quick question here.
Yeah.
So we have assigned the particular user to this financial offerings, right? So, I mean, can't we see the user from assigned to column?
Assigned column you cannot see. If you want to see, you can see from the different place. I'll show you that. From here, you will be able to see that.
Okay, fine. Okay.
So see here, like you can see for all these tasks. So two users are assigned. In the previous session, just this is a user which we used. And along with that system, now we assigned one more user. So cloud, it is showing. If you place the cursor here, the pop-up, it is showing. Okay. Now just you can click on this username. I'll just select it and you can click on
Lakshman. Can I restrict the user only with the particular option and task? Suppose we have the financial module. In financial, I want only the asset, the one user, he should be only can view and edit, I mean do the configuration only for assets, and he cannot see other modules. So if I'll suppose I am the application consultant setup.
In that case, see, you know what happens is when you assign the application implementation consultant, within that role will have access to different offerings and options. That means it will have access to everything. If you want to limit, you have to create the custom application implementation consultant role. Within that, you can specify for which module the role will give the access. So if you assign that role, which is you defined only for AP access, so that user will be able to have access to only AP related setups. By customizing, you can do it. You see here,
I have to give the access for FSM, and because he should have the FSM also, because he will do the configuration.
Yes.
And inside FSM, there is will be a okay option, and inside option there will be a limited task.
Exactly. How you are getting access to FSM? Because of application implementation consultant. By default, you will be getting access to FSM, okay, for all the options which are available. But now whatever you can do is, whatever the seeded role we have called as application implementation consultant, you can copy the role, which areas that user doesn't require access, that you can remove, or else you can create the role from the scratch. I'll just definitely will focus on this point also at the time of role customization process. But as a point I am giving now, you can do it. Okay. If you see here, this task is assigned to these two users. This user is permitted. Okay, that means this user can do the setups, but the cloud user cannot do any setups. Not permitted. The reason, the required roles are not available for the cloud user. Cloud user, we don't have any roles which will give the access to do this kind of relevant configuration. Okay, so here you will see the same information. If you look at these tasks, whatever will be performing the relevant module or anything process. So here you can see exactly, if you want to specify the supplier numbering, the user required access to which role. Those you can see, authorized roles. Through which roles you will be able to do the setup for this task. Those you can see from here. Just click on details, you'll have a big list. I think this is, environment is not showing. Basically it has to display the list. Just wait for a second. So in this environment is not fetching. I'll show you that. I'll show you that. Just okay. Just this information is missing, seems to. Okay, I'll show you how it looks like. I'll show you in the different environment. Okay, this won't become an issue. But once you click on that, it will be displaying which role people, which roles will have access to specific tasks. That's how we'll be able to see. Okay. So that's how just you can assign anything just to any user, and if you want to remove also, just same process. Just you can select particular task, just click on assign tasks, or specific offering or option you can select, then it will display. So now you don't want to allow this user anyway, since this user doesn't have permissions, you can remove, or else you may assign the required roles to that user. That user also will be able to work on this task. And you can update the status on each and every role. Say for example, you completed this task. In that case, you can update the status. You may set the status to completed. So this is just for information. If you set completed, okay, you don't need to think system is not going to allow us to work on it. It will allow. Just for information, the status tracking purpose, we are setting to completed. Still, you will be able to work on this task. It will allow you. Okay, it won't have any control on that. So this is a
What is the due date for?
Due date, you can set the due date. Say for example, whatever the setup you are going to do, for that you can set the due date also. For example, I'll go and do on setup. So manage procurement agent. So I'm going to select the multiple set tasks. I'll select this. I'll hold shift. And I'll be selecting these four tasks. I selected first task, then hold shift, then select the fourth task. Four tasks are got selected. For this four tasks, I want to assign to one resource. See here. I want to assign to someone to complete that task. The username is, say for example, we have Cloud Double A. I'm assigning these four tasks to this user. Now I can specify the due date, by which due date this task should be completed, so that this would be tracked against the project. Within the due date, how many tasks are completed, okay, how many just got delayed, and all that information will be able to see. Just say save and close.
Will they be notified, Lakshman, about the task assignment?
So, no, that kind of option we don't have. It's a simple, like, just it's all about tracking the information. That notification and all, we don't see anything here. Just the user who is working, just they'll be able to see that. That's all.
So this
okay,
is
Lakshman.
End date of user, right? The due date and the end date would be different, like it doesn't.
Yeah, end date means it's normally if just due date, we have to treat as end date to complete the task.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Lakshman, I have a question here.
While assigning the task.
Okay.
Okay, while assigning the task, okay, so there is a list of users is appearing. So can we say those users which are appearing in the list, they having the FSM setup?
No. All users will get displayed. Which user has access? System will be showing that other here. If you just click on this, for which user has authorizations to complete the task, it will be marking the status. By default, all users, whatever the users you have in the system, it will get displayed. See here. So these two users are not authorized to perform this task. That means those users doesn't have required privileges. Required roles are not assigned to those users. All users will get displayed.
So red mark is only for the not permitted.
Not permitted. They cannot do any task here. They cannot perform any task on this since they don't have required privileges with respect to roles. Okay.
I have another question on the assigned user. So I see here Cloud ERP as assigned user.
Correct.
So only that user is allowed to perform this setup. For example, I see here manage payment terms, right?
Yeah, if you log in as a cloud user, you cannot complete the setup, even if you have just assigned to this project. So to do this setup, you require access to application implementation consultant. First, you assign application implementation consultant to this user. Then this user will have access to FSM. And by default, they'll have access to everything. But they'll look at the assignments, which task is assigned with their name. Then they'll start working on it.
Okay. Let me take a specific example here, manage payment terms. So only one user here, right, according to you, Cloud ERP, only should be able to perform this setup.
Yes.
So what if there is another project, and then in a different project, the same task is assigned to different user. He has the access to manage payment terms, right?
Yes.
So that means not necessarily one person has access to this manage payment terms.
Yes, exactly. Who has access to application implementation consultant, they can access that. They can
so have, pretty much everybody can.
Everybody, yes.
But can you limit access?
For that, we have to do the role customization. We have application implementation consultant. It will give the access to entire system. Finance, HCM, procurement, okay, PPM. For all the areas of setups, it will give the access. You can limit for that access whatever just you are going to get from that.
Okay. Yeah. Got
you. We can do that. At role customization time, I'll just take you through that point. Okay. Yeah. One more point here, just majorly this we are not doing just for controlling purpose. There is no much control in based on the status and all. Only the point is here just to update the status, which user is working on, which process, how much percentage of the project is completed. Now see here, if I just go and mark, for example, I'm just going to mark this invoicing into say payables, edit status. I'll just update the status as completed. I'll say save and close. Still, we can go and do the setups. Now, I'll go to the project level, see how you could be able to see that information. So here says not started, around 788 tasks are not started. And this says completed, 263 tasks are completed. Just now I updated the status for payables, as a payables related configuration is completed. And here you can see in progress. Okay, in progress. So that's how you will be able to see that information against the project. This is all about assignment status. In the same way, assignment status by task list. Task list wise, okay, the assignments you can see. Okay, so task list define common application configuration for financials not started. These many tasks are not started. So these many tasks are started. Yeah, that's how you can see that information here. Okay. And again, you can see resource status. So how many resources are working for this project? As of now, just we assigned these two resource assignment we did. Okay. So that's how we did. And the assignment details here, you don't get anything. It's not.
Lakshman, I have a question. Yeah,
please. You could hear some noise, so going. Yep. I'm sorry, there is some noises.
Can you hear me now?
I think, yeah, now it's fine, please.
Yeah, Lakshman, I just have a question about, you mentioned like there's no way for notifying the user that, let's suppose the project manager assigned you these tasks. So I'm assuming like, you know, there should be some kind of strategy, like, you know, I'm writing an email to those users. These are your assignments.
See,
and these are like my due dates.
I got your point. Let me answer. See, the point is, it's just a one-time job which we'll be doing. When we are working as a resource, we'll be knowing we'll be working for which area. Think the manager is not going to assign, so based on some requirements. It's all about, if you are going to work for financials, you'll be knowing you have to work. The assignment also not mandatory. This is just for information. Say you don't have this feature in the application, the project manager may just do the activity called as assigning financials to you in some third party, some tool or some dashboard or some sort of project management tools, whatever you say. So in that case, you may not get notification, just will be intimated saying that you are going to work on financials or else payables. That's it. So we are not going to do this activity as ongoing, where the users or consultant has to keep getting the updates. If it is a process related, definitely. It's just one-time job assignment. Again, it's not mandatory. So you are working as a finance consultant, you'll be informed that you'll be working on the payables. That's it. So just for information, we are keeping that in the system. If you are assigned to payables related configuration, I can go ahead and I can do the setup. System is not going to restrict. If I have access to function setup manager, anyone can go and do it, but normally, like, to who is responsible for which area of implementation, they'll be doing. That is the reason there is no that much focus on these points, where some notification should go to the user or not. So that's how they are not, by default, they are not giving all the features. Just it's a one-time job, just status tracking, that's all.
Lakshman, following that question, just to my curiosity, the thing which you're showing, the map, this whole chart, implementation, project details, is there any way as like project manager or lead for this, you know, project, can I export this like on email format or Excel?
The status reports we have, separate reports they're given. So the reports you can generate and this you can submit to someone.
Okay.
Yeah, FSM related reports we have, which will show that project specific status, and that you'll be able to, you can download those reports and you can share with any other team members or management. That we can do it.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Fine. So this is all about just the project creation and all. Now, once you create the project, okay, after creating the, already we have seen how to just update the status and how to assign to the one or multiple resource. So this is information we have to understand. So apart from that, when you start with the fresh instance, what is the first step we have to complete? So for taxation purpose, as well as normal, the address definition purpose, we have to enable the geographies information. Okay, we have to enable the geographies information. So the first step would be, we'll create the project. After creating the project, we have to set up geographies information. So here, there will be a task called as manage geographies. Okay, there's a task called as manage geographies. Just click on this here. For which country you are going to implement, for that country you have to enable the geography related address style. Okay, for every country will have a different address style, right? So that address style we have to enable, or else you can define how you want in the fresh instance. By default, you don't find any predefined address style. You have to set up that will be using throughout your setups as well as process. For taxation, it's very much mandatory. Okay, so let's search for US. So task name is manage geographies. This task you don't need to search from the project, directly from FSM, Functional Setup Manager, you can search it. Directly you can go to FSM. Task is here, setup and maintenance. Click on user. Okay, then it will open the panel. You can go to setup and maintenance. You can search for the task called as manage geographies. Search, you can find the task called as manage geographies. Just click on manage geographies.
Lakshman, you did mention the navigation for this, right? If we are just searching and go to the search screen and we can do it.
Yeah.
But
yeah. One point. So this is not very specific to project. It's instance level. Okay. This is instance level. Okay, so since it's instance level, I am just showing in the FSM. Okay, if it is a part of some project and offering, even if it is a related to, see, for example, I'll take example, manage payment terms. From here, if you are searching for anything, it won't show any navigation. Okay, direct task. If you are doing from the project, then it will show the navigation. Okay, so what are the tasks we won't be having as a project? Say, for example, there is some certain task which we have to complete, which are not belongs to our financials, but still those may have some dependency. Those tasks we don't find within our project, because within our project we have only financials. The task may be very generic setup. Those you have to search from FSM only. The setups which are specific to project will be searching from the project, or the setup, the task which is belongs to the specific offering which you have in as a part of our project, those all you can search from the project. Rest you can search from your FSM, where system will be able to access those task entire instance level. Within the instance, if task is available, it will display. But if you search from your project, so say for example, within this instance, we have PPM, SCM, HCM, financials. But if you go to your project, you'll be able to find the projects which are there, I mean the tasks which are there within this project only. Here I can search and find only finance related. I cannot find inventory related, order management related, and purchasing related. Okay, so these tasks you can search directly from FSM only, because this is a very generic, okay, which will you can find at instance level. So when you say manage geographies, it's not specific to your project. It is instance level where you can set country wise. Okay, against the same country, you may have one or multiple projects also. Okay, it won't be project specific. That sort of task you can directly perform from here. Fine.
Okay, Ken, is it good to assume that if we are not able to navigate, or if we are not able to perform a navigation, it is good to assume that is it is common configuration across the
So just now I shown that example also, manage payables account, payables calendar. Okay, that is part of your project. If you search from the project, you can see the navigation. This is something like some kind of shortcut directly without navigation, you can connect to that function. Okay, anything you can search from, but all the tasks you cannot perform from here, which got some dependency related setups like ledger related, BU related, you cannot do from here. Yeah, please.
Yes, Lakshman. Suppose if we are going with this geography setups, right? They are perform in EBS. We perform that using the trading community architecture.
Yes.
Okay. Like the there is a specific responsibility wherein we go and perform that.
Yep.
So, when you are performing these geography setups, are we performing using that particular role, or how is it?
See, it's not a specific role. This application implementation consultant will have access to entire system related functionality. I mean, for all the offerings. When you talk about this task, this is related to TCA. The TCA model, as is, we have in the Fusion also. Okay, this is related, but can be accessed directly with this task. Okay.
Sorry, Lakshman, I did not get it.
No, what I'm trying to say is, it is connected with the TCA model only. Okay, TCA model only. Now we are not going to deal with the TCA model related definitions and all. Okay, what we have to do is, when you are going to start with the system, we have to make sure that for the respective country, the geographies information is defined and it's active and validation is set. That we are going to check it.
All right. Yeah. Thanks.
The simple point we have to understand here, this we have to set up. Okay. It is, when you compare with EBS, it is part of TCA only. Okay. Okay, just search for this task, manage geographies. Just click on that. It will take us to the page from where you can search country specific geography information. Okay, here country name and country code will go with the US, and just click on search.
Lakshman, sorry, this is Lakshman Gayakwad, and just one small question. When we think of this with Oracle, we have at least the implementation guide where we have the setup tasks available, right? Here as well, I see that on the FSM homepage, there is a setup checklist available.
Mm.
But when I was referring to that, I didn't see anywhere like this kind of managed geography. So is there any more hidden steps? I think in Oracle, we do have that step mandatory that you need to run this particular managed geography step. But how to identify like this kind of step is also required to do. If we just blindly refer the setup task list, we may miss some more important steps like this, right? So
that we have to just say that you may not have a very complete documentation. So this all definitely you have to do from learning certain things. So in finance, you can only find a finance related task list only. This is a very common. Okay, this is very common. For common, they didn't provide any offering also where you can choose and all.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. That's what I was referring to, common setups. That's right.
Yes, yes. There is no separate offering. Yeah. Fine. If some sort of document is there, we can start working on that, no doubt on that instance. So that is the reason just we are in discussions now. Fine. We'll focus on this point. Okay, definitely those also will try to understand. Okay, we'll focus on this. If you take example, you are going to do the implementation for US, what we have to do is we have to just look at all these points. Okay, first you just search for that country with a code or name. And the first point what we have to do is geocoding defined. You don't need to do anything in the initial stage. This would be, let's say now it is a tick mark. Okay, but initial stage it would be like this in the fresh instance. What we have to do is you don't need to do anything. Just click on that arrow mark icon. System will be updating as a completed. The backend system will be marking the status as we enable. In the same way here also the status also. Address cleansing defined, it by default it would be like incomplete status. So I'm clicking on that, it will reset. One second here. Okay, it's not undoing. Basically it would be like in the same way you have to click on that. Here functional front, you don't need to do anything. As a process, what you have to do is first you have to click on that system will be enabling, as well as your address cleansing defined also you have to click on that, it will be marking as completed. From here we have to work on relevant information. Okay, structure defined, hierarchy defined, validation defined. First we have to define the structure based on the country. Once structure is defined, the structure related, by following the structure you have to maintain the relevant values. Okay, whatever the states or cities and postal codes or county, what are the information you want to have as a part of structure that we can define, then you can maintain that hierarchy related information. That within this instance you can have information, or else you can load that particular country related address format related information to the system based on the structure which you are going to define here. Well, I'll take you through this process and I'll tell you in the fresh instance how to do it. Just try to understand these points. So if you are going to do the implementation for a country like US, you have to search for that. Okay, you find it. Now you have to click on, first just click on geocoding defined. This will get enabled. You don't need to do any other activity. Here also just click on that. It will give pop up and say, okay, it will be enabled. From here, how to work on it. So just click on this. So here already address style is defined for this country. Okay, state, county, city, postal code. Okay, here you can see predefined geography types which will support multiple countries related information. If you think, okay, for which country you are going to define this geography structure, if you find the geography type is not available for that country, what are the different geography types will be creating? If not available, you can click on create and add geography type, that will come in this list of values. call it a state is there. That is the reason I am just selecting a state one value. So that will come in this list. You can select the state one. Okay, so I just added that, got added in this. So I'm going to delete it. So here you can select in the first instance, you don't see all these things, you have to select it. Okay, so first you will be in this, that again level also important to highlight in the on the top state and the state county, and within the county city, within the city postal codes. So this is the sequence, this is the hierarchy you have to maintain here. In the first instance, this is what we have to do. Okay, I'll show you with other country also, then you can understand. Once you complete that, please.
As you see this, so all these state, city, county will be there already. Like
I'm coming to that point. I'm going one by one. Yeah. Okay. I'll just take you to all these just points. Then, if you have any questions, definitely, yeah, we can talk on that. Ultimately, we should understand what exactly this, how it works. Okay. So just first you have to, first these two points here, just you click on that, that will get enabled. The next point is geography structure. So you can select the structure hierarchy here. And if you find the value is not available, you can just create from here and you can do it. Another point here, you can copy different structure information also, that I'll show you. So once you're done with this, what you have to do is in the fresh instance, you have to go to action. See what we are doing. First, you have to enable this, again enable this, then define the structure. After defining the structure, so three steps you completed. As a fourth step, you have to go to actions. You have to go to actions, and here you can find that one option called as import Nokia data. Import Nokia data. Here already we selected country called as US. For US and other countries, Oracle is maintaining predefined data in the system instance itself. Within the instance, they are maintaining predefined data. So what we have to do is, you have to go to actions, then you have to click on import Nokia data. Once you click on import Nokia data, what system will do is, for the selected country, what are the address style we have, okay, structure we have, by following the structure, it will be loading the data by following the types, whatever you defined in the system. Okay, see, within the instance, they are maintaining the data. The source of data they are calling as Nokia data. Okay, wherever this all the information, the country specific, okay, states, counties, cities, postal codes, okay, whatever the other address styles will be, geography types will be having depending on the country, all the information they are maintaining within the instance. What we have to do is, you have to create the structure, then you can go and run it, then system will identify and it will load the data. As per process, what we do is enable, define the structure, then fourth step, go to actions, then click on import Nokia data. This is not fresh instance, this is a vision instance which you are using for practice. Within this instance already that is submitted, that is the reason you can find it as a grayed out. Okay, grayed out. So before you submit, it will be enabled mode, just click on submit, that would be completed within couple of hours. If there is some issue with that instance, performance issues, it may take day time also, even that is a client instance, it may take one day time, but ideally it should be completed within the couple of hours. So we'll go to the actions, you click on import Nokia data, it will submit the request, it will be running, that you can confirm as that is completed from the schedule process window only, right? We know how to navigate it. So we'll go to the schedule process. There you can see as a system submitted that job and the status also. Once you identify there it is completed, then you can click on hierarchy defined. So by following the structure, what are the counties, states, cities, postal codes we have for US, okay, as within this instance as a source. So those will be loaded, those you can see from here. Just click on complete. Just click on that complete. Here you can see all as loaded. Okay, so the country is US, within that all the states your system will be loading. So here just expand that, within the state counties, within the county we'll have a city, within the city, postal code. So what is the source for this data? From where Oracle is taking? Okay, name data provider is Vertex. Okay, from Vertex they are taking. Again, we have option here. You can load that the Vertex file also into system. The Varamas file which we upload in case of EVS, in the same way here also they give an option where you can submit the data. That's how you can get all the information to system for our taxation purpose. But ideally this information they are keeping within this instance only. Whenever you click on Nokia data, automatically this will get populated based on the structure which we define. Okay, yeah, any questions here please?
So just like you said, Vertex, and I understand Vertex is one of the sales, tax, you know, software.
Correct.
Any tax, you know, software can be imported data into Oracle. There's no limitation, correct?
No, it's not like that. Some Oracle validated tools, you can do it. Okay, there is some other tool in the sense, in that case, you have to get the data from the from that, and here we have a template. So Oracle is providing the template. You can keep all that information within the template. The template information you can load it, because this Vertex, Sabrix, okay, right? Some other tools, Oracle validated tax service providers. So for that reason, these instances are compatible to load the data directly into the system, but not all
tax
tools.
Yeah. I see. Okay. So so let me rephrase. So what you said is like the template will basically validate first before it loads in the system.
No. What I'm trying to say is, if you are going to get the data from some third party tools which are not validated by Oracle and where this application is not compatible to load, say Varamas, if you take it's Oracle validated service provided data, so it will allow. So I'll show you that navigation also. You can go and submit. It's just a job. You can load it. Okay. So if you are going to get from some third party vendor, separate template Oracle is providing. So from where you are going to, you can get the data from anywhere, any source that you can keep in the template. That is very much validated template. You can load the data into system.
Okay.
Yeah, that's how we had it. Yeah. So here, if you want to create the new state or new country, a new city, all you'll be able to do it. Okay, that all you can do from here. So for example, I selected city here. Under that city, I want to create just another postal code. For example, I can select here, I can click on create, or else I want to create city. In that case, I have to select county. I'll select county, then I'll click on create. I'll be able to add any value if required any point of time. So that's how we'll be able to add the value here. That's how we can do it. I'm just canceling this. Okay, here simple task is just we have to submit the Nokia data. I have to submit the Nokia data. This is how all the information will be loaded. Okay.
Hi Lakshman, I have one business scenario.
Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, Lakshman, suppose I have this setup and there is no change for US and UK. So can I have the multiple geography like US and UK?
Separate geographies you have to maintain. For each country you will be maintaining country specific. This is.
So in that case, the instance will be different?
No, like see, you have it two countries, you want to maintain the geography information, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you can just same instance. So for multiple countries you can have, just this is one country I'm showing. Now we'll look at for India. So India here already that this task is already completed. Import Nokia data. Once you click on that in the first instance, that would be loaded. How that got loaded, you can see here. All this is just data which is available country wise. That's it. You can expand it so you can see all the states. You can just expand any one of the state. within that, just the value within this environment selected as a county. It's nothing but districts basically. If you expand any one of the district, you can find the villages. Okay, the value how you take and type accordingly it will display here: country, state, county, town. That's how just selected in the test environment. Okay, in one instance you can have for multiple countries, definitely. Just you don't need to maintain separate instance for each country. We'll have a separate structure definition, country specific. If you look at the structure,
so the Lakshman, first we need to create the structure.
Yes,
or just we can directly do the import.
No,
it will take automatic structure.
No, here you have to create. So that's how it will take. Okay. So first you have to define this hierarchy. Okay, levels nothing but hierarchy. This is how we have to create. And we'll go with other points here. So just enable, then define the structure, then load the data. Just click on that, automatic system will take care of it. Then validation define, this is very important. If you look at here, the different points, the same geography types and map to attributes. So enable list of values, tax validation, geography validation. So we'll go one by one. So here, enable list of, first we'll go with this geography validation. When you say geography validation, say you are going to create some address. When you are going to create address, you will be finding this state, county, city, postal code fields in the address creation. It can be supplier address or customer address or any address. So when you say geography validation enabled, by default, say for example, you are not enabling these values. Just you enable only this. In this case, whenever you create the address, these fields you can see because of this geography address style definition, but you have to enter all the values as a dynamic values. State name you have to enter, county name, city name, postal code. Okay, so that is the meaning of geography validation. But instead of entering through manual process, if you want to get all the predefined values in the LOV, you can enable it. You should normally will use this one. Okay, so we'll enable it. Geography validation enabled undo, enable list of values. Since we are going to get the values from list automatically, that is a validated information we'll be getting. If you don't enable it, you have to make sure that definitely just this is enabled. That system will have a validation when you are creating the addresses or whatever in the system related to tax related definitions and all. So other point is tax validation also required. Okay, if you are going to use the same information to do the tax related configuration, say for example, when you are doing the setups for taxation for US, you are going to derive the tax calculation based on say ship to or bill to. In that case, definitely you have to depend on these values. Okay, so say you are just calculating the state level tax, and if it is ship to location is going to be shown, so state tax need to be derived. In those scenarios, you should enable tax validation. Okay, before you just go and do this, anyway, we have to look at as a part of tax configuration also. You have to make sure that this information is enabled here, then so everything will be working fine. Whatever the data you have for the specific country, which is available with the task, with the function called as manage geographies, all those information will be available. Whenever you go and select that country, the country specific address style will get displayed at the time of address creation, as well as it will open the LOVs. Otherwise it would be dynamic field. You have to enter the dynamic text into that. And at the time of taxation, tax need to be calculated based on the derivation of this any one of the geography type as per your business requirement. You have to enable this. These points we have to understand. Just make sure that these three are enabled when you start with the instance uses, so that in your setup point of view or any other point of view, this would be available. Okay, so this is the point we have to understand. Any questions here, please?
So, Lakshman, this is done only for the address validation, correct?
Address and tags. Here you can see that address style format. The same will be copied. There won't be any difference. We will define one system will take United States postal address format as well as same it will take for tax address format also. No style format also it will take.
I just wanted to know this.
Yeah, please.
Lakshman, we do have address validation. Suppose if we are creating a customer, right?
Correct.
The address validation goes by line number one. Line number one, in terms of identifying duplicates or anything like that. So suppose along with line number one, if we want to have line two as part of that duplicate deduction, is there any provision in Fusion to do that?
Line one, line two, it's a dynamic test which you have to enter. Okay, basically the actual validation would be the predefined geography types only. Okay. Fine. So with these only you can have a actual validation. Those just it's a test, you can enter anything. You can make some character difference or space or anything in the one and two, line one and two, just that system will accept. Those are not predefined, right? It's not you have to maintain a seeded. Actual validation would be with these geography types only. Fine. Here this is a point we have to understand. Okay. Any questions, please?
So yeah. You showing that these steps. So when we create our own projects, then we have to.
Can you be loud, please? Voice is not much audible.
Okay. What I was saying that when we are creating our own project,
yeah,
so we have to go through these steps like import and Nokia data.
Instance level setup. It's not project specific setup. Okay. When the
hi Lakshman, if I don't select the hi Lakshman, I have one question. If you don't select the no style, then we can't update the address as means anything.
Address you can create, but there won't be any format. Okay, there will be some very seeded where based on the country, 2-3 fields you'll be getting, you'll be entering the dynamic data. I have seen few clients who are I mean, for whose solution is rolled out without specifying this information. Because the initial stage of consultant is not aware of this, they'll proceed with the actual configuration. And what they are doing is, for any address they are creating, everything they are entering very manual process, manual data they are entering. Okay, and later, if you realize this point, okay, you didn't enable this information, then what are the definitions they completed already, say supplier site related information, supplier address or customer related address, those all will get failed. You have to do it in the very beginning stage if you want to do it. Otherwise in middle, if you are going to do, you have to take care of all the definitions which are already existed. So that is the reason, as a first step you have.
So that means we should not provide the no style, right?
In that case, see, if you don't need any style and all, ignore it. That would be very manual process when user is creating the address. They say they are creating one address related to US. They have to enter the state name. They can enter wrong test. They have to enter the city name. They have to enter the postal code. There won't be any LOV. Okay.
Lakshman.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, I have one question. Currently, I am working on Oracle Finance 11i, where when I go to the address window, I found that initially we select the Northern European as a territory, and then under that we have the address style created, and in that again we select the country as a, let's say, Netherlands or Belgium or any European country which falling
on. You can see the list of countries, all you can see in this environment. So
Okay.
the other region, and that's how they are not giving straight away country names they are giving. You can see that list of countries.
No. My question is not that. My question is that we have here selected that US as a country, and we have imported all the data related to US. But then, if I want to select like European countries, because our setup, we have a different European countries. We have to give
Country
the
specific we
addresses
have
for the
for
customer.
European, for each country we have a separate. Okay,
Okay.
country specific you can search and you can do it. So you have for each and every country separate. Okay.
Okay. So right now we have created the address style as a US, right?
No,
If
for
I don't mistake.
yes, for US address style, how it is defined, we have seen.
Okay. So I can define the multiple address styles for one instance, right?
One instance for each country, one address style. Country
Yeah.
specific.
Yeah.
That is
Yeah.
a
Yeah.
very important point.
Okay.
Yeah, fine.
Lakshman, I just have to clarify. I think so we can create one address style for each country.
Yeah.
Now, for Canada,
One
they
address
don't
style.
have a state, they call it as a province.
Yes.
So instead of the city county, you can make it as a province instead of the
You
state, right?
can have
For
however.
each country, you can define
Yes.
that. Yep.
Yep. That's true. Okay.
Okay.
For that provision, that all everything the Oracle is providing the data, but what are the element type you are choosing accordingly, system will be loading the data. Okay. Fine. So these are the different countries here you can see. So by default, this
And
is
I hope, let's say, we choose, let's say, 3 to 4 different types, and we miss one, or tomorrow we have a requirement to add one more address line, then we can again go back to this address style and add that, right?
So no, that would disturb everything, the definitions and all. In that case, definitely you have to, normally that such kind of requirements we may not get. That case we have to keep in touch with Oracle how to manage
Okay.
the case. That's it. Okay.
Okay.
Fine. See, by default this is how you'll see for these countries not defined in this instance. Okay, so for example, I'm just selecting this country, Bolivia. So just click on that, or you can search with the name or code. Search. So here geocoding is not defined. Just click on this. This is how we'll find in the first instance. Just click on this. It will be enabled. Enabled. Address cleansing. Not enabled. Just click on that, the pop-up will come. Just say save and close. Now define the structure defined. You have to define it. Just click on this, it will open. Okay. If you want to say, for example, some other country address structure is similar, I mean this country address structure is similar to other country, in that case you can copy some other country, just address style is similar. In that case, you can select that country. Before that, make sure that for that country, address style is created. Then click on apply, it will get created. Okay. Otherwise, what you have to do is normally just you can go with the just option one second. Just create only. Just like cancel that one second. So click on structure defined. Then click on create. It will give us option to select the geography types. So on top what you want to have. Okay. Say for example county on top. Add it. Under that, what is
Lakshman, could you explain what cleansing does, Lakshman?
That is just in the just it's all about for system understanding. They given that, so we have to see that what is the background of it. Okay, as a process, what we have to do is just it's all about enabling where that that will allow us to define the structures and where that will keep this definition active. Okay, means the cleansing might be something like some activation process within the system. Okay, this is how just you can add and you can proceed with that. For few countries, the Nokia data won't be available. Only the option is you have to load through some spreadsheet only. For this country, Nokia data is not available. It's not because of it's submitted, it's not available. For few countries, it won't be available. Okay, again, we have other tasks where you can load the data, separate task you can see here. Say, for example, load geographies for United States. Search for the task load geographies. US. Yeah. Load geographies for US. Fine. Here you can just process the data here. So validate import elements. You can select here. So what is the source of data you are getting? Data source, vertex. Okay, only the vertex only they just given for the validation. Another point is a spreadsheet. We have other spreadsheet there. You can take it. File location you can specify. File name you can just give here, just run pre-process and then post-process. This is how you can do it. Since there is no parameters, so it's not taken for next step. Okay. I'll take you through the template. The templates and all comes under rapid implementation. When we load that, our chart of accounts and ledgers, business units, legal entities, all we can load into system through rapid implementation. At that time, I'll take you through the templates, which are different templates available as a part of rapid implementation when you're doing the finance related implementation or some dependency related imports, which you have to do as a part of implementation activity. Okay, I'll take you through that information. Okay, so this is a task. Just remember, in the first instance, make sure that you are just completing this task. Otherwise, if you go to any address related definitions and all, you will be finding that as a empty. Here I'll take you through that. Say manage locations. If you go to this task, say create. You don't need to take this point just for understanding. I'm taking you through this. Okay. So here, if you look at this location definition, okay, just you can provide this name and code, anything that we'll discuss anyway, detail level when you create the location. But here, if you look at the country, when you select United States, okay, so here also like EBS, we have a profile option as where every time this United States will get default, whatever the country you set accordingly, it will default. In this environment, that profile option is enabled. So you're able to see that. So based on this country here, you will be able to see all the information, city, state, zip code, and county. So all these information is coming based on that. So if you don't set enable that, hope everyone can hear me.
Yeah, now I can. Yeah, we can hear you.
Fine. So when you look at this address definition, so in this environment, the profile option is set to default as a country called as United States. That is the reason it's defaulting. So based on that country, that address style is getting defaulted. If you don't enable this, whatever we discussed, the manage geographies, here will be finding the information as a blank. and very limited by default format. Oracle, what Oracle is providing, that style will come. It may not come what exactly you required, but generic style it will be displaying, but there won't be any LOV. You have to enter, like these fields will be finding those fields, like these dynamic fields, these fields also will be finding. You have to enter the data. When you enable validate address, I mean validation, like we have a LOV, other one is tax validation, other one is geography validation. If you enable geography here, if I write any city name, so system will verify, and it will validate. If it is exact name, it will accept, otherwise it will reject. That would be a big task for the user who will be creating the addresses. That is the reason if you enable that country, accordingly it will come. So here we'll go with other country so we can understand that. So for example, so I think this is a, for this country, we don't have any address style defined. So we didn't create any address style, and we didn't enable any validation. See, that's how it, that is the reason it is coming like that. By default, this is how Oracle is providing city and state. So all any city you have to enter, any state you have to enter. That's it. So that is the reason we have to manage geography setup. We have to complete so that you'll get all values ready, and those you can select from LOV. That's how you can work on this. Location definitions, not only this location, any location when you are working, when you are creating the supplier customer addresses also, same will be applicable there also. This is how it will be reflecting. Okay, so that is the reason we have to complete the task called as manage geographies before we start with any system related configuration. Very, especially it's required related to addresses, but before we start with implementation related configuration, we have to keep it ready. Okay, so this is the point we have to understand when you talk about this manage geographies. I think already we reached 9:30. Okay, maybe in the tomorrow session we'll start with the calendar chart of accounts definition. Any questions on today's session or any questions from previous classes, please let me know. We'll discuss on that.
Lakshman, one question, Lakshman, regarding the locations.
Yep.
Okay, in EBS, whenever we define HR locations, right, when it comes from AR, right, when customer location is created, a customer address is created, there is an address validation program that gets kicked in, like the geo naming reference.
Yeah, here also same.
And when there,
here we directly we have option also for submission. Okay, when you create location,
mm-hmm.
we'll review and we'll submit where it will trigger the job. Here the request only we are calling a job. Okay, yep, yeah, that's what we can do it. Meantime, I'll be showing, we can go ahead if you have any further questions.
Yeah, when we do our HR locations, let's suppose if we are doing it from purchasing, let us consider, when we do locations from purchasing module, the address validation does not kick in, and we need to again go to the backend and do those all queries, find the location ID, then run
point.
The
I got your point.
Okay,
you have to resolve that issues. So they're given a separate function called as create locations. It won't be from purchasing or HR or somewhere. By default, all are belongs to HR locations only. Okay, so you can find this task from any offering, but it, the source would be that. So like in EBS, when you do from the different application, you have to go and do manual work. That is not required here. Here, any location you can create from the same page, any location. So we'll be providing the information, you'll review it, then you can submit, it will trigger the job. Means it's a process that you can see from the schedule process also. That's how it works.
Got it.
Yeah.
Lakshman, is it a centralized I can use in any offering?
Yes, exactly. It's a centralized.
Lakshman, after copying the role and when we compared copied role and from where we I copied the role, both are not exactly same. Why?
You are talking about what? I didn't get you.
No, when we copy a role from and copied to another role, right? Copied a role, suppose I copied IT security manager.
One second. I think we didn't discuss any copy roles so far.
Okay.
No, we didn't discuss, right? You are trying to just understand that point which is separate from our class, or what exactly? I didn't get you.
Okay, no. My question was, when I copy a role and then compare,
okay,
it is not exactly the same.
Okay, so there are two options would be there. Okay, include a hierarchy also, then it would be same. Copy role,
okay.
There will be first option. You might have selected a copy role. If you go with the copy role hierarchy, then it would be same. I mean, it would be same as it is. It will be copying everything, the inherited roles which are there within the source role.
Okay.
Your question is apart from our discussions, right? So,
yeah,
fine. That's how you try with the second option. When you get pop-up, first one system by default, it will select copy role with inherited roles. There will be second option. Try with that. It will be copying everything as it is. It will be same as your source. Okay, that's how you can try.
And I have one more request. While doing, can we maintain a document like Excel, which we are doing for in first through three classes, maintaining a line for each and everything which you are
doing?
We are doing.
It's required for this today. Manage geography is just one task, right? Again, within the definition also, we have in sequence. When I'm going to create calendar,
yes,
chart of accounts, primary ledger, any definition, I'll be writing in the sheet so that we can have.
Yeah, so this when we refer this sheet, we will get the exact sequence what we have to do.
You can understand. When I'm writing, you can make a note from your end also if you require. So that's
yeah,
all.
Yeah.
I'll list out. I'll be listing out what we'll be doing. Yeah, I'll be writing in the sheet. Yeah. Fine. So any other questions from any?
Lakshman.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lakshman, one more question. When you create a location, I saw the inventory organization, but is it business unit specific? I didn't see that. Or
no, if you want to limit that location for specific inventory, then mark inventory. Otherwise, not required. If you want to, the location is common. In the same location you are operate, you have your warehouse, you have your HR organization, you have your business unit, everything. In that case, don't give any specification that can be used for every definition.
Okay, so but there is no, I didn't see any column for like business unit.
No. There is no,
there is nothing
for inventory only. You can specify rest, you cannot specify here. You may put some hint within the name definition, or else, well, business knowing that the location for what.
Okay.
Yeah, for everything that
yeah, that's what
provide.
Okay.
Yeah. So any other questions from today's session, or based on previous discussions, or what your practice related, please let me know. Fine. So we'll connect tomorrow same time, and we'll start with the calendar creation and chart of accounts. So we'll proceed. Any
questions? Okay, Lakshman. Good day. Bye.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you all. Have a good day and good night.